Live from Copenhagen, Denmark, it's theCUBE, covering KubeCon and CloudNativeCon Europe 2018. Brought to you by the Cloud Native Computing Foundation and its ecosystem partners.
Hello everyone, welcome to theCUBE, exclusive coverage of KubeCon 2018 here in Europe, Linux Foundation. It's theCUBE's coverage. Again, we're covering the KubeCon Cloud Native Conference, part of the CNCF. I'm John Furrier, your host this week here in Europe with Lauren Cooney. Lauren, great to see you.
Thank you, it's great to be here.
Cloud Native is hot. Obviously the Cloud Native Compute Foundation, CNCF, part of the Linux Foundation, driving really an pretty incredible growth.
This is tremendous.
Onboarding, I mean, the logos, it's just pretty massive growth in microservices.
It's just, you're seeing so many interesting things that are actually coming to this show. You know, there's over 4,000 people here, I heard. You know, the taxi line was 20 people deep this morning to actually get here for the keynote. And, you know, I got to say that, you know, some of the technologies that are coming out are just really tremendous. And we've got some great folks that are going to be coming on the show. Lou Tucker from Cisco, and then we've got Tyler Jewell, who's going to be talking about a new cloud native programming language. I think that's pretty interesting.
And we got some great influencers as well. We're going to get the commentary. But you know, the big story is we're in Copenhagen, Denmark. The sun's shining, it was raining yesterday. But again, Europe, great European city. Feels like Amsterdam, got the canals. But the growth in Europe, it's just, it feels like I'm in North America in just terms of the volume. It's not like a satellite show. Normally Europe, you see kind of the US, North America, big tent events, and then Europe's kind of like a sidecar, no pun intended, event. But no, it's pretty massive. I mean, you're seeing great developer uptake here in Europe. Cloud is hot, Kubernetes is the talk of the show,
you know,
Istio, among other things.
Exactly, you know, I think I've been talking to folks around the conference center, and so many of them are actually learning this for the first time and bringing it back to their, you know, large banks or some of their employers, you know, huge European companies that are actually looking to adopt this, and I think it's just phenomenal.
I was chatting with Abby Kearns last night. I told her I'd give her a quick plug here on theCUBE. She's CEO of Cloud Foundry, and we were having a chat. She just did a survey as part of the Cloud Foundry group that found that outside of our bubble in Silicon Valley and certainly in the influencer sphere, most people have heard of Kubernetes but actually don't know what it is and kind of where it's going to be applied. It's one of those things where it's really taken the world by storm, certainly in the classic enterprises, but application developers are seeing the goodness of what Kubernetes will do when you look at multiple workloads, workload portability, microservices, as the growth of applications become cloudified.
I think
Kubernetes is key.
It's key, and I think the projects that really are inside of the CNCF are obviously super key as well. Like Spiffy, who actually detects kind of workloads and types and, you know, does that in an automated way. So, you know, the user doesn't have to figure that out anymore. I think those technologies are really the ones that are going to be, you know, changing the landscape of platforms, you know, now and to come.
Yeah, so Dan Cohn's up on stage, Lou Tucker's up on stage, talking about multi-cloud, obviously from Cisco's perspective. Lauren, you're out there on the streets working with some startups and big companies as they start to transform cloud. What do you see as the key themes of the show? What are the notable highlights for you that you see on the agenda? And what are some of the things you're looking for this week in Europe?
Well, I'm definitely looking to find out really what the news here is. You know, we've got some new projects, we've got some new end users, we've got some awards that are handed out. I really want to get to the root of what's new and what's happening. I think that there are some interesting things that are happening around. You know, we know that growth is explosive in this community. I think that, you know, is very clear. What I don't know is you know, kind of clear to me yet at least, is really how large as CNCF has gotten and how it's really going to kind of fit together and how users are going to take advantage of that entire ecosystem, because there are just so many partners now and users. How do you actually pull that together in a way that's going to be workable from, you know, the perspective of a platform?
To me, the big story I like here, and certainly what's notable is, and worth talking about, is the role Google's playing. If you look at this show, you got some Microsoft here with Azure, but really Google's at the centerpiece of this. Obviously Red Hat and all the other industry players are here as well. But Google is driving a lot of open source standards. This is a real kind of, I won't say anti-AWS show, but it's kind of like you got Amazon reInvent and then you got everybody else. And this show represents to me everybody else, because there's a real emphasis on multi-cloud and workload portability. Again, not getting locked into one cloud. Google's pretty upfront about that. And they're betting on open source to be that lever to get a good position in the cloud game.
Well, it has to be. And I think really what's interesting too is that AWS did show up here. And they had a, you know, I was actually bouncing between some of the trainings that were going on with FIDO, one of the projects, and also, you know, what was going on with AWS. They called it their awesome day. And there were a lot of folks attending and a lot of folks interested. So I think it's going to be an interesting game here, John.
Well, we have Adrian Cockcroft coming on, obviously. He's with AWS. He's leading the open source efforts for Amazon. And again, not to poke at Amazon, but you know, Amazon is so busy and they announce so much at reInvent. They're so ahead of the game on cloud scale, just the number of services at Amazon. Has had significant impacts. We covered Amazon's earnings last week. Again, a 50% increase. The profit that AWS is throwing off is so notable and so impressive that it really is a bellwether to me in terms of this cloud transformation. And the key is applications. That is the number one focus we're seeing and how that makes the cloud scale an impact. What are you looking for with applications? What's interest to you there with the applications?
Any applications that are running from public to and private across that environment, but I want to see multi-public cloud environments as well as on-prem, you know, or private environments too. That to me is interesting.
Yeah. Well, I want to get your thoughts on another topic that we're going to talk about this week, and that is the role of the personnel inside the organization for cloud transformations. So for instance, the role of the admin operators out there, or admins and operators. We saw certainly at Cisco DevNet Create that we were recently at, the role of the network manager is moving much more cloud-oriented, programmable infrastructure. But you're seeing Google starting to talk about things like automation is good, but yet the role of an operator, they call it an SRE, site reliability engineer, as the key position for cloud. What's your thought on the personnel equation for cloud within an enterprise, within large companies?
Well, the SRE is the new hot role to have, right? I think that there is an increased interest in that audience because they are actually the ones that are troubleshooting a lot of this and looking at a lot of what the strategy is and where to take these things. I think that, you know, it's also interesting because as people are looking to aspire to different roles, this is one of the ones that has become more established and is kind of shined upon in the developer world right now. And it's going to be interesting to see if that stays that way or if, you know, they're going to be, you know, what's kind of going to happen there.
Thoughts on microservices in context to Istio service meshes. Again, last KubeCon, we talked about Istio, the service mesh piece of it, with the notion of a modern architecture. How is that playing out in your mind?
I think it's playing out pretty well. Everyone seems to be on this Istio bus. I also think that, you know, when we talk to Lou Tucker, for example, I think we really need to ask him where he sees it going and what's going on with Cisco and the ecosystem at large on that. But everyone is playing and playing nice with those guys.
Yeah. I'm interested to get the security update. We're going to have some Google folks on. I want to find out what's new with that. And obviously Google Next is coming up in July. Their big cloud show, I'm expecting to be that. Pretty large event. Google is really going all in on cloud. Certainly the cloud group within Google's got a lot of investment, a lot of enterprise folks. But the security question in Kubernetes is an interesting one. How to deploy, you know, endpoint security, or is it an IoT thing? Is it chipset to operating system to application? I mean, this is the open question on Kubernetes security.
I don't have a good answer for it there. I think that, you know, that is something we definitely need to dig into as a community and as developers. It's something that, you know, I think it was mentioned in the keynote today, and I think we got to continue to poke at that one.
Awesome. Well, we're here kicking off a day one of 2 days of coverage here at CNCF's KubeCon. I'm John Furrier with Lauren Cooney, back with more live coverage here in Europe, in Denmark. We're in Copenhagen for Cube coverage at KubeCon 2018 Europe.